some clear felling around here, so that's never really that pretty. But when I was round here the other week, I did spot a few cracking trees from in all this mess up here where they've clear felled. And let's see if I can find it again. There's one. That's the tree. That's what's happened there. And it's obviously gone over in the wind at some point and snapped back to this dead wood. And we've got a branch coming out here and a lot of nice growth that's come off of this way. The tree started to grow for that branch there. But, you know, there's nice usable branches right back down here. And essentially, I use that bit there. This bit here. In here. I mean, if we was to chop this back in there to that branch, lose that, lose a lot of this, and leave it there for another year or two, investigate what's going on down in here a bit more. But this, I don't know if you can see that, the whole root ball's moving there, so that's, it's just hanging on to the side of the hill really. It's lucky to escape. Lucky to escape what happened with the when they clear fell. It's like, whoa, it can be pretty horrendous. And I'll show you this tree from this angle. So, a real genuine sort of, I haven't chopped the top off and made it look like deadwood. That's real, that's the real deal there. So there's a lot of other stuff, you know. There's your tree there, with this lot here. That's your tree. Forget those other bigger branches. There's your tree there. And I dare say at some point in the future it probably will be. It's a cracker, mate. So we'll come back to that at some point. And, oh my god, I have found a gem. I have found an absolute gem of a tree. So I thought what I'd do is we'll go and have a look at it right now. And whilst the iron's hot, it is literally, look at all this, had a little bit of wind. A little bit of wind and a lot of trees just gone. It's just nature doing its thing, I suppose. Interesting though, when you you look at these trees up here, when they go over, how much root they pull up. In relation to bonsai in pots, the scale's probably about the same really. You know, anyway, let's go and find this tree because I'm super duper excited about this. It's in there. If you can't see that, well, we're going to go a bit closer. So bear with me. Camera's on tripod, so we've got to climb up here now. So This is what I'm saying about the root size. Look, that's the roots that tree's pulled up. In relation to the size of the trunk, Anyway, likewise with that one there, that's the root ball, mate. That's the roots for that tree there. It's quite surprising how shallow and how little they are. Right, here we are then.
Okay.
That's a Douglas fir, but my gosh, something's happened at some point there. And it's got a bit of movement in that, and then it goes that way a lot. But so it's had something happen to it quite early on, and it's put out all those other branches. But, let's have a look from around this side. Yeah. See, that does have Yamadori potential.
I mean, that's a good size. And it's already got some dead wood going on in there. Some had a deer have snapped the branches off. Some larch cones up in there, but I'd probably lose that big heavy branch there.
Take you over there and have a little look at that. Oh.
that's about where we're at the moment. I think, you know, maybe if that lot there came off, might be a nice tree going towards the left there. But anyway, thought I'd share it and see you next time.